Welcome back to my channel, everyone. So, as you can see, today we are not working with a deco mesh wreath. We are working with grapevine. I purchased this 18-inch grapevine wreath from Joann Fabrics. It was on sale for about $4-something. It was usually $6.99. So what I want to do before I start doing anything to it is I want to kind of just clip off some of these. I like some of them to be long, but some of them are just a little too long. So I like to just come in here and clip those guys right off. I think we're going to use this side as our front side. See, like that twig was just way too long. It wasn't even going in the right direction either. So yes, we are actually making a fall wreath today, and you're probably thinking, why in the world is he working on fall when it's not even May yet? Well, if you're in the wreath business, you know, you have to work ahead of everyone else. Like, it's only April, I don't even know what the today's date is. I think it's like April 26th or something. Wait, it's April, yeah, 26th. I look at my calendar. Yeah, so it's April 26th. The next holiday is 4th of July, or Memorial Day. And I already have all my patriotic wreaths completed for this year. As I know. If I get a custom order for one, I will make another one. But my just regular old make and sell wreaths are for patriotic are done for the year. I had those done probably about last week. I think I made my last one. I've sold a couple of them already. I have done some summer already. I don't do too much summer because a lot of my wreaths for spring kind of are summery and springish, if you know what I'm saying. People like to keep them up. I have a couple of custom orders. My next video is probably going to be me making a custom order. I have to make a swag for someone. They bought a Christmas one, and then it came on like a board, and you could take the swag off the board. But now they want a swag to go on the board for summer and spring. So I made an order on the wreath shop the other day. It should be here sometime soon. I also had another custom wreath it wasn't a custom, but it turned into custom now. They just made just one of my regular old spring make and sell wreaths. If you don't know what make and sell means, I basically have no intentions of anyone buying it yet. No one custom ordered it. I just make it, and then I put it on my Facebook page to sell. And hopefully soon I can start. I'm actually going to be starting an Etsy shop pretty soon, guys. I just need to buy a laptop because I don't have one right now. And the one that we have at our house kind of broke. So I need to get that going. I need to get our printer working. And then I'm going to start my Etsy shop, you guys. I'm excited. I've been watching videos lately. Just getting ready for this because I'm so excited. It's time for me to get my Etsy shop going. I have a couple of people that are interested in making a couple custom orders for like their house, basically more like for a just like an everyday wreath, where they could just put it up in their house as their normal decor, no seasons. So yes, so I'm working on fall in the middle of end of April. I'm really kind of just bored, so I decided to come on here and make a fall wreath because what's not better than a fall grapevine wreath, right? So yes, this is just going to be one of my make and sell wreaths. I have no customer asking for it yet because everyone's not thinking about fall. They're thinking about summer, even though it's going to be a terrible summer right now since everything's going to be closed due to the coronavirus. But we'll get through it. The wreath makers still need to make. So that's what we're going to do. So I did have this sign for my stash, since I don't have any false signs yet, because I haven't made my mass order yet online about for fall yet, because I got a couple more summer ones that I need to make, but while I'm waiting for them to come, I just thought I'd use up some of my materials in my stash for fall. So I do have this sign, but I don't think I'm going to use the sign. I think I'm just going to go with a bow, nice big bow, and just add florals. And I have a couple, I got these pine cones on stick, on wood stems. I think I might use some of these. And I just noticed, like, these guys, when I was using them before, these things have, like, pokey things on them. So I have a whole entire basket of pine cones on stems. No flock or no snow on them. So they're perfect for fall. I have my whole entire basket of florals, you guys, for fall. As you know, I use the garbage, or I don't know if they're really garbage cans, but they kind of look like garbage cans. So yes, these are all florals that we'll be using. Different florals. So that's what we're going to be doing. The ribbons we're going to use today are, I haven't decided yet. I think I'm probably going with the leaf instead of the pumpkin. It's either the leaf or the pumpkin and then this gingham. Check. But I think I'm going to go with the leaf, and it is 12 feet. I think I got this. I think that's from Michaels. I'm not sure, though. I'm pretty sure Celebrate It is a Michaels thing, but I could be wrong. I'm pretty sure it is. I must have got this a long time ago. And then I got this stuff, this ribbon at the wreath factory. No, I think that came from Craft Outlet, actually, now that I think about it. So we're going to make our bow first. As you guys know, I make my bows from hand. I need a basket to put this on so this doesn't go all over my floor. So you guys, I did an online pickup from Joann's, because I actually got these grapevines today. I needed some more grapevines, so I decided, since I live in Wisconsin and we have to go longer with this quarantine, they decided to open up craft stores for just curbside pickup. So I'm in their whatchamacallit, grapevines were on sale. So they had seven of them. I picked up all seven. And then I got the email or the text and to come pick it up because it's ready. And I got there and I called and they're like, okay, what's your name? Blah, blah, blah. I said my name. And they're like, okay, you got the text, right? And I'm sitting there outside with my door open, watching the girl looking around, and I'm like, okay, I'm like, well, I got the text, so hopefully, I'm like thinking, okay, well, and then she walked back, because they had it all in like the doorway, since you can't go in the store right now, they had all the bags and stuff in the doorway. Well, then all of a sudden that she comes out with a shopping cart, and all the grapevines were in the shopping cart. And she just I was gonna grab them out of the shopping cart and post them in. Well, no, she kind of budged out of the way, and she took the grapevine wreaths and just started chucking them into the thing. Well, not really chucking, but throwing them in there. When I was taking these out of my car, my whole backseat of my car was literally leaves and twigs. I'm like, oh my gosh, now I get to go. Tomorrow I'm going to get to have the fun job of vacuuming it out. After I just vacuumed it out the other day. So, enough of me rambling, because I've been rambling for 8 minutes. While I was doing this, I was going to get this out of here. I was actually going to shove some more glue sticks in my glue skillet. I got my hot glue skillet plugged in. I don't have my hot glue gun plugged in because I don't think I'm going to need that at all today. And I have an Amazon order coming. I bought a wood burning tool, so that way when I make my flower wreaths, I don't have any fraying. And I bought a big box of hot glue guns and a new skillet because my skillet is very tiny and I need a bigger one. So I got an 8-inch or something skillet. So hopefully that'll come soon. It said it wasn't coming until like May 22nd, but I'm like, why would it not come until then? That's a long time away. Hopefully it doesn't come at that time. Hopefully it's here before that, because that's like another whole month away, and I'm like, but we're gonna get going before this video turns into a 3-hour long grapevine. Shouldn't take too long because I don't have to do any poofs with my deco mesh. But so comment down below, you guys, if you make wreaths or if you've made wreaths before. Do you like working with deco mesh wreaths better or grapevine? I'm honestly, I can't really decide. I love working with both of them. They're both pretty easy. Deco mesh is fun because you can make them real full and everything, but grapevine are a little bit easier, a little less work, because you don't have to kind of put the wreath together. It's kind of already put together, and now you just get to decorate it. But I love them both. So I just use my rotary cutter just to cut the end, but you don't need to use that. If you don't have one of them and you don't want to buy them, a scissors is fine. Since we're not going to be cutting any deco mesh in this wreath, you don't really need your rotary cutter. But we're going to be doing just a regular bow. I'm trying to think how big I want my tails. Probably about a 10-inch tail. Yeah, that's pretty big. I think about a 10-inch tail. And then I just poke it down. And I come in here on this side. And I think I'm going to do about a 6-inch loop, maybe. Yeah, probably about a 6-inch loop. Okay. So, yeah, I think about a 6-inch loop is nice. Okay, and then I just cut. So what you're going to do, if you need a Bodabra or you want to make it with your Bodabra or any of your bow makers, go ahead. I tend to just use my hands because I think it's easier, to be honest with you, for me. But I know some people might have arthritis in their hand or something else that kind of enables them from doing that. So I just measured out a 12-inch thing, and then I kind of make sure that they're about the same height. So I do one above, one below, and then I cut. But for this one, yeah, I cut. Okay. I'm confusing myself, you guys. Don't let me do that. I tend to confuse myself a lot. So, and then I'm going to come back in and down and do another another tail. And then I'll do the same thing like I was doing with the loops. Just like so. And cut. Cut the tails. Okay, and then you come back in here and you do one more loop. I kind of bring up my tail. Kind of come down here. Match up my loops just so they're about the same size. And then I cut my ribbon. And then that is our loops for that one. I'm going to be done with that ribbon for right now. I don't think I'll need it again, but then we got this one. Got to pull the needle out. And I always shove my needles, not through my hand, but into this basket that's over here. That way, I'll just stab it into this hot glue stick. That way I know that my hot glue gun, or my needle, is not on this table, because if you put it on the table, you have the risk of knocking it off the table, then not finding it, and ending up finding it in your foot when you step on it. So I always put my needles in a container where I know it ain't gonna be falling anywhere on my floor, because I've had that happen where I lost a needle from my ribbons, and yeah, sure enough, he was on the floor. Thank God I realized it not when it was too late, but so what I'm gonna actually do is I'm gonna actually maneuver. Well, actually, no, we can do that later. I'm not worried right now. Okay. See, guys, I kind of confuse myself a lot. So if I didn't tell you, I'm using one 2.5 and one 1.5. So the one we're using right now is a 1.5 inch ribbon. And then the leaf one is a 2.5 ribbon. So then we're gonna come back down here and we're gonna do one more tail. So basically we're doing two loops on top and two on the bottom. And then you can just cut your tails. I just cut my tails like that. And then we'll do one more down here. So by this time, it's no longer kind of in your fingers. It's the ribbon is kind of making its way to the palm of your hand. If you guys have realized, you don't need to pull it down. You don't need to sit here and pinch it hard as you can because it's just going to make your hand cramp. Hold it real gently. As you can tell, I'm not squeezing it. I'm just holding it in my hand enough that I know it's not going to go anywhere. So don't think you need to sit here and pull on this thing, making sure it ain't moving a bit, because then your hand, that's how you do hurt your hand. So I'm coming in here with a pipe cleaner, going from the front to the back and just twisting it. That way I have a nice tight thing. And then you can go in and start fluffing. You could use floral wire for your to help put your bow together. I don't. I use a pipe cleaner. It tends to be a little bit bigger. That way I can, and it is easier for me. But whatever is better for you, you use. You use whatever you want. Whatever works for you. For me, it is a pipe cleaner. For you, it might be floral stems. Okay, so now what I'm doing is I'm just kind of coming in here and floofing. Or fluffing. You can call it floofing. It kind of sounds fun. And then I'm just coming down here and I am finding my tails. You should have two of each. And kind of bringing them down. That way I know, because they'll be coming down the ribbon. Or they'll be on the bottom. And then your ribbon bows and tails will be on the top. So then I'm just coming in here with my tails, kind of working them behind a little bit. I kind of tend to just use the ribbon tails to help it kind of stay in place. That way I know. It actually kind of works for me a little bit better if I add it onto the grapevine or the whatever wreath. It doesn't have to be if you're going to add this onto a deco mesh wreath. Whatever wreath your palm you're using, it kind of tends for me to, it's easier for me, I'm trying to say, to add it onto the wreath. You could use a wreath, like I know people make, they make like these boxes with a hook, and then they just use that, and they hook their thing in, and then it helps, then they can pull on it. I don't need anything fancy like that. If I add it to my wreath form, it tends to work a lot easier for me. So you're gonna decide how you want it. So I want my tails coming down here, coming down. I'm gonna have this like this side being florals, and then I want the other side kind of being if you know what I'm saying, kind of. I want my grapevine showing. So I have to decide. It's kind of pointy, as you guys can tell. So I'm kind of deciding. I think I want that kind of just over there as a little bit of feature, and then I just kind of sit here and I just trying to just bring my pipe cleaners down through the grapevine twigs. Make sure you have it on a couple different twigs, that way you know your bow ain't gonna come loose at all. I have it around a couple of different twigs. It is gonna be a little messy. This grapevine has a couple different bunch of different leaves and foliage, which helps bring out the fall. If you're using it for spring, you might wanna, or to be honest with you guys, I think it would even be better if I just put the, now that I'm looking at it, I think I kind of want to cover up this pointy edge because I don't like the way this is looking. Okay, plan B. See guys, when I don't cut out of these videos, I kind of not going to cut out of this video since it's my first grapevine on this channel, so I kind of just want to save this for anybody that's kind of new to, if they're beginners and they're trying to watch me and figure out how I do it. Once I start having more videos, I'll probably cut out and just tell them in the video to. Okay, why isn't he coming out now? Okay, there we go. I think it's still. Oh, there we go. There we go. So yeah, I think I want that guy just covered up, and he ain't gonna be showing in this wreath because. I don't like how it's like that. Okay. At first I thought I kind of did, but now I'm like, nope. We don't like the way you look. So yes, when you're buying grapevine wreaths, especially like when you're like me and I did online pickup, or if you're buying and then they ship them to you, you kind of just have to hope that they're not all kind of funky, because they're not always going to be perfectly circle around. You're hoping that they are, but they're not all going to be like that. This is one of the better ones that I got. But you just have to figure out and work with it, and it helps bring it a little bit of different, like, featuring. Kind of gives it a little bit of character if it's not fully circle. That's why, like, if you're like me, I'm covering that up because I don't want that perch showing. And you're not even going to see it. So I'm just twisting this on. I'll fix the pipe cleaner in the back and kind of make sure that it doesn't scratch anyone's door at the end. So I don't want too long tail. I didn't want too long of tails because I wanted it to be able to, because it's going to get covered up by the florals and the different things we add in later anyways. So that's why I kind of left them a little shorter, but if you want your tails to be longer, go right ahead. Or if you don't want to have tails, long tails are like me at all, you do whatever your heart desires. I ain't stopping you, and I'm just showing you, I'm just going with what I like. You go with what you like. You may be a long tail person, and that is totally fine with you. You do you guys. That's what people say. My teachers used to say that to me. You do you. So if you don't like how some of the tail, like the shorter tails, sometimes they go through when I cut them a little bit more. Like this little guy, he kind of might get a little annoying. You can also shove them in the back and use that kind of just I use those a little bit, especially when you're working with deco mesh, because you don't have all the different crevices of the grapevine. But if you're using deco mesh, I like the little tails because they help me give a little bit more that I can attach my florals or my picks or whatever I'm using to. But in this case, I am using a grapevine, so I don't really have to worry about that idea because I can stick all my florals right on down into the wood. I don't know where my other, oh, there we go. There's my other stem, or not stem, tail. Okay. You come over here. Okay. I kind of just work with my bow a little bit here. And then I kind of just come back a little bit later and I kind of figure it out a little bit more. Just get the gist of it right now. Figure out what I want. Kind of make sure I have all my different pieces in there, because you guys saw this guy didn't get involved into the wreath, and he was hanging out back. And he's one of our precious loops that we need, so we don't want any of our... ribbons, bow loops to get just get buried, get hidden. You want them all showing, since we don't have that many loops in this wreath. Okay, so I kind of liken the way it's looking a little bit right now, it's not 100% to my likings, but I do know that it's gonna get covered and it's gonna get messed with when I start adding florals. So I'm not real worried right now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna kind of come in here and figure out what I kind of want to use. I got this like grassy kind of stuff that would look cool in the wreath. I have these flowers. I don't know. They bring out a little bit of, I don't know. I'm just using my scraps, you guys. So I got some different picks. I got some garlands too, I think, actually. I think those are all downstairs. But I got these leaves. They're kind of a little dingy looking. Little need to be brought back to life a little bit more. I actually think these must have came from, I think these came from, I don't even know where those came from. Okay, those ones got sparkles. We don't want that. No glitter in this wreath. This is a fall wreath. Okay. These guys are pretty cool. These guys would look pretty cool in the back a little bit. We gotta bring them to life a little bit more too. But what I think I might start doing is adding a little bit of my bigger, grassier kind of what I decide to use for the backings. So we got some leaves. We might be able to add some leaves back under here, and I'm gonna kind of cut these guys off. I think my hot glue is getting hot over there. So what we might do is just start with some leaves back here. Yeah, we're gonna start with some leaves. Okay, so add some hot glue. Especially since I'll be selling this, I wanna make sure that these guys are gonna be in there and they ain't coming out. So we're gonna add some of these leaves as our beginning pieces. You can add some greenery, and then get into our flowers. I don't have too much greenery on hand right now. That's why I'm trying to kind of go with some other options. So you're not gonna see these too much because they're under the bow, but they help start. And since they're not one of the beautifulest things, they're not my main focal. They're not one of the things I need showing, like, completely. They're not, like, the flowers are, like, what you want to see. That's why you put those on towards the end so you can actually see them. As you can tell, starting with this, your bow is going to start getting funky and it's going to start messing up because you're going to be going in and lifting up. That's why I'm not too worried right now about what it looks like, the bow, because I'll get through it. Okay. I think we're gonna come in with some of these leaves now. Pull the tag off these. I don't know where these came from. I don't know where a lot of this greenery came from. I did actually recently buy out, I bought some lady was on Craigslist and she was actually selling a lot of different crafting tools, a lot of wreath stuff actually, because she didn't, and there was a lot of different stuff. So some of this could have came from her. I just don't really know. My hot glue is just like really odd. Like some days it's like really not really, really liquidy. And then some days it just doesn't want to. It's real gloppy today. Like, I don't know why it is doing that, but it is. It doesn't like to cooperate today. So we're going to have to just work with it and figure it out. Kind of mess with it a little bit. That's why I told you guys I need to get a new hot glue gun. And it's on its way. It's supposed to be here hopefully soon. I ordered it. Our hot glue skillet, I don't know if I called it a gun. Might have to bring out my gun. These leaves are a little bent, but you need to play with them a little bit. This, I don't need a, I don't have a, I'm just kind of wedging these guys right down into the wire. Okay. I don't know if that guy came through the back. No, he didn't. Okay. Well, we'll figure at the end. We'll, if anything comes through the back, we'll kind of get that at the end. We'll trim those guys off at the end. Whatever comes through the back. That way. So we got different picks and different fun stuff. I don't know. I think this came from, Michael's. Kind of looks like it. They're kind of a different type of leaf. They're kind of cool looking, so we might use a couple of these. So this wreath, I can't just tell you everything. Where it's one wreath, or what I'm trying to say is this, I can't, it, all the supplies didn't come from one store for this wreath. They are from all over. A little bit of everything. So, and just start poking it in there. You'll get it to your liking after a while. You might not like it right away, but you'll get there. I'm not worried. You just keep on adding. Just keep on adding in, and eventually it will become, it'll come to your liking. You can add as much into your, behind it, or as little, whatever you decide. I'm just adding my leaves, basically, as my backing, and then just to help bring it out a little bit, and then eventually I will come in and I will start with my flowers, and my, like, different grasses and things. I got this, like, corn cob type stuff, but I don't think that's gonna look good. If I'm being honest. So, gotta find some more in this bin of fall. I don't really know what to use if I'm... I just came on here and decided I'm gonna make a wreath. I'm gonna just start adding in stuff. I'll figure it out as I go. And so I didn't have any specific florals picked out. I just brought my bucket up here. That's what I usually do for each season. I bring my summer up, my different color florals, and I just start adding. Okay. To be honest with you guys, I actually might. I don't know if I'm gonna like this. Okay. I might go and grab my bucket of greenery. I have some greenery that I might put in here quick. So I'm gonna go off, go find that, and then I'll come back on. Okay, I got some of my greenery. So we're just gonna add them in. I don't have too much greenery, you guys, so if this video might not end, or I might, for you it'll be all one video, but this might not all be one day for me. I might have to wait till my shipment comes with the different other greeneries that I bought, since I kind of used a lot of my greenery and I didn't rebuy a lot when I should have. But that's my mistake, so I'm just kind of using some of this different greenery that I have and kind of just using what I got. So, just using what I found. I had a bucket of different greenery. This is like a greenery stem that I kind of took apart. Those are leaves. I don't want those. But no, I have some greenery coming sometime soon. I bought a bunch of greenery online. So when that comes, we might have to just wait and hold off. Might be a start and a, oh, I put it to a halt kind of wreath. It's not like it has to be done or anything pretty soon because we still have all summer yet, but it's a start. But we'll kind of work with what we got and we'll see how I like it after I add this greenery. We can maybe add in the pine cones. I don't know. This leaf right here, this guy is throwing me off, so I might actually just go in and pull this dude out. I'm not liking the way it's looking, to be honest with you. Okay, so we're gonna just pull him out just like so. Cut whatever he pulled out. Oh, he pulled out a little bit of. So yes, that's the nice thing. This is not like fully secured in there yet. It's still not as solid. So you can still have time to pull those guys out if you put enough pressure on them. So yes, we're adding greenery because you really should always add greenery into your wreath, no matter if you want to. It just helps bring parts of your wreath alive before you kind of start with the whole florals. It just starts as a base and it gives you something to start with. I thought maybe it would look better if I just started with leaves, but then it has too much color, if you know what I'm saying. Then when you add your flowers in, it's just like, wow, what am I staring at? There's too much red, there's too much orange. So you need that greenery to help bring out the different colors and help neutralize it and not have wow, what am I looking at? The flowers, the leaves, the everything is the same color, and it's like they all like combine together into one thing, and then it doesn't look good. So you need the greenery to kind of bring it all together, if you know what I'm saying. Sometimes you don't need a lot of greenery, sometimes you do. I don't know if I'm gonna need a lot in this one since it's a bigger enough bow, and I think my flowers kind of have the greenery attached to them already, some of them. So I kind of have the greenery coming out a little bit. We need a little bit more under here by this flower. And then we'll get to the flower part of our wreath, and we'll see if we're gonna add our pine cones in or if we're not. Like I said, I have no plans for this wreath. I just wanted to start my fall because fall is one of the favorite seasons to make wreaths for. It just is one of my favorites. It's just the leaves and the different colors. It just, to me, it's like one of the favorite. I'm not saying that I hate all the other seasons, but it just, one of my favorite seasons. I'm actually going to pull this guy out too, I think, because I don't like the way it looks. I think they're too long and they just don't look right. They look kind of cheap. And I don't like that. Because I don't want my wreaths to look like they were real cheap. I don't know where those leaves came from and don't want to use them. So I'm just fixing my bow because I have OCD about it and I want my bow to be looking good on camera. And you guys can't even see this. Wow. You guys probably didn't even get to see half that. And I apologize. Still new with this whole YouTube thing, and I'm not used to having to make sure everyone can see what I'm doing, because when I'm just crafting away, and my wreath is going all over the place, but now I have to get used to centering it, and I keep moving it. There. Keep it right there. Don't move it. So, we're gonna see. I'm gonna come in here and try to find some of my smaller pine cones. I don't think we need something. I think a bug just hit my window and it kind of scared me. Okay. Why did this guy come apart? Yeah, guys, these things are sharp. They got like pointy things on them that like stab into you. They're like prongs and they're like Like, get away from me. Owie. I never really felt a pine cone like this. I don't know what its ordeal is, but it just doesn't like me. It says, get away from my home. This guy came off his stick, and I don't have any green floral tape up here at the moment, so I'm gonna come in with some just regular tape. And you're not gonna see it, so it's not like it's gonna be that bad. I just want to make sure that it doesn't come off the stick. We'll add some hot glue to it too as well. That way we know it's really not going to go anywhere, but... Sorry for that noise. It's probably really bad on it.
Probably really bad.
This phone kind of picks up everything. The worst of noises. It's like, oh my gosh, seriously? Okay, we're gonna see if we want pine cones in here or not. I think that's too long yet. I don't know where that guy went. But we can always add them down. Kind of poke them down in there. See if you want them in there. Ooh, that looks good. I like that. Okay, I like that. So we're gonna add some hot glue down in there. Bring them right down in there and poke them right down in there and kind of hold them there for a little bit. I'm gonna bring some of my greenery on this side. That way it kind of shows in the different directions. And I might always come in here after, if I finish this video, if I finish it all the way through. Not wait for my greenery. I might always just come back in here and kind of fix it later on. If I decide, ooh, I might need some greenery at the end. I can always come back in here after I have all my flowers in and add some of the greenery that I get. I was just ready just to make a wreath that I just, like, I don't even care if I don't really even care if I have any materials for it. I'm just so eager to make a wreath that I just am going to start. And then I kind of forgot that I didn't have any greenery, so. I used a lot of it for my spring. Before I started YouTube, I've used a lot of my greenery on some of my wreaths. And then as soon as I started YouTube, I kind of got done with my grapevines for spring, and I just started doing my deco mesh, so that's why you guys didn't really see a lot of my spring ones, but you will next year. So I'm liking the pine cone placement. I'm not sure if I want one down there. Maybe a smaller one. I'm kind of using smaller guys because they're kind of nice. This guy's a little bit smaller. I might need a little bit of tape on here because I don't want just for a little bit of extra stability. These are actually wood picks, I think. Wood floral picks. You can buy a steel pick machine. They are a little expensive, but if you get into the wreath business and you start making a lot of wreaths, eventually it could be an investment that you decide to go into. So far, I have not invested in one yet, but I can see myself in the future probably finally deciding to invest in one. Right now, I'm just like, I've been slowly investing in some of the bigger things, not trying to just go out and buy a crap ton of stuff right away. I'm just taking it slow. So what I'm doing now is I'm just coming in with some of these grasses. Make sure you fluff and get them different ways. You want them to look real and not all come jammed into there. So there we go. So yes, wood pick and green floral tape work fine too. As that was what was on these pine cones, is just some floral tape and some wood picks. But yes, you can invest in, I think this grass came from Michael's too. Pretty sure this is Michael's. You can kind of tell by the label. It's not Hobby Lobby, I know that. But I'm excited to go on and start placing an order for the start of my fall wreaths. I kind of like to start with fall and then I mix in some Halloween here and there, and then the next thing you know, you're starting on your Christmas, and then you're like, Christmas, 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 and then the year is over, and you start again on Halloween. Before you know it, you're back to Easter again. Back to Easter, and it's like, wow, the year has flown by. This guy kind of decided to go out on me. Kind of just helping him go back in a little bit. I don't know why he decided to do that, but he did. So we might just go in with like a little floral pick and stab him in, add him there. There we go. Put some tape on him too. This little guy came off of his stem, and I don't want to just add a wire into the skinny little wire. That just wouldn't look right. Or it probably wouldn't stay, actually. So we'll just come in with a little bit of and I just lift up my bow and just start placing it wherever I think. And then I kind of just bend it and go wherever you think looks good. Okay, I think this guy's going to go together. And I think he's going to go back here a little bit. It's a little bare back there right now. So I'm just adding the smaller grasses. And if you want to add like your bigger, like I added my pine cones, now's a good time to do that. And then I go in with my flowers and my, that kind of stuff. I'm going to kind of bend this guy over here a little bit. Bring a little bit of love over there. Come back in here a little bit. Kind of moving my leaves down back a little bit. Bringing a little color in, but I don't want him to be like the focal point right now. Bring my other stuff in, and then kind of fix my bow, because you know me. My bow has to be perfect, otherwise I get anxious. So, coming in here now, I'm like, so I use that grass. I might come in here with some of these bigger flowers that I decide to use. Ugh, hack loose strings, they're gonna get annoying after a while. These guys are gonna go over back there. Don't need those right now. Clean up my mess a little bit. I'm gonna come in with these, I don't know, they're called Gerput daisies. They're a little fluffered out, so we're gonna come in here a little bit and fix them a little bit. Get them a little bit nicer looking, kind of fluff out their leaves a little bit, and then put them in the hot glue. Okay. Swing that around a little bit and then come on down in here and start placing. You can bend them a little bit. Like that. I'm just gonna pick them. Ooh, something went in my finger. That did not feel good. So yes, once you start adding your florals, don't think that if you don't like them, you can't, they're stuck there now because they're not. You just can go in and mix and mess with them a little bit. And if you decide that they do not look good and do not meet my expectations, you can always pull them out. Take a pliers, or you can even take like a take your hands sometimes. Sorry, I started talking and then I'm like, okay, what was I talking about now? That happens to me a lot. Get very easily distracted on this when I'm talking. Just kind of wiggle their way in. They will figure out where they want. They'll find a hole to go down in. You don't want them getting crushed by your bow, or you can always just move them a little bit. So what I'm doing is, hot glue is getting all over these things. I'm coming in here, gonna come down in here behind this bow, grab the grapevine, hold it so it doesn't move when I'm doing this, and then poke it down in there, like so. A little bit back there, and then push. Okay, and then these guys need to get pushed down a little bit more too. So, sometimes I like to bring out my I'm going to have that pine cone down here in the middle of my tails. I got to kind of move this guy so he doesn't. Oh! See, I don't know what is on those pine cone needles. They hurt. They keep stabbing me and they do not feel good, guys. Literally, they don't feel good at all. It's like that's like thorns on them, and it like stabs you and hooks you. I don't know why. Never seen pine cones like that, so I don't know what's their ordeal, but something. They're like rose bushes, they stab you. Like, maybe it's to keep the squirrels from chewing on them. They want to save themselves from the squirrels, so they decided to grow needles on them or something, because I don't know. But it does not feel good when you get poked by them, and I'm trying to move them, and it, like, stabbed me right in the finger. So if you can, and these things are on wire, so you can always move them. Okay, so I got them flowers done. Now I need to come in with something a little bit more, I don't know. I just think that it's a little too much. What is this? Foliage bundle. It's pretty sad. Actually, I think it's been cut already. Okay, I think it needs a little red, to be honest with you. I think it needs a little bit red. So I got these red leaves. Maybe we want to add a scarecrow? We could add scarecrows. I got these pretty cool, dope little scarecrow guys, but no, I don't think we're going to use that. Never mind. We got these guys. I think I'm going to add these guys in there. Add a little bit of different texture and add some little berries or whatever those are called. Little cheap little styrofoam guys. Okay, I'm like stabbing it down in there. And I cannot. Oh, that's why. Funny, I was stabbing it into the bow, or into the ribbon. And I'm like, why isn't it going anywhere? Okay, well, there we go. There we go, he was like, I'm going into the bow. You ain't taking me anywhere else. Okay. Oop. I'm just, for all these guys, I'm just taking my wire cutters and snipping it all off. No, I don't know where that guy went. I think right here. Yep. I'm just dipping it in my hot glue and shoving it down wherever I decide that I want it. There we go. Kinda don't want them covered. There we go. Fluff my bow because that's what I do. And then we got one more guy of these little thingies. Little berry bushes thingies. Whatever you would call these. My finger is like tingling from where that guy stabbed me. Like literally like full on went right in my finger and now I can feel where it happened. Okay. So I added that guy in down in there. I still think we need a little bit of red. I feel like we got enough yellow. I got these red, I don't know what the heck you call them. Or we got like these red thingies. What are these called? Sunflowers with buds. We got these little sunflowers. They're kind of, they're a little funky looking. They don't really remind me of sunflowers. They don't look realistic. Okay, we'll just keep digging around here in this floral department of my crafting mishaps. Okay, I think we're going to take apart this fall foliage garland. Whatever. I think that's a dollar store or something. Who knows? I get stuff from everywhere, so it could be literally from anywhere. And I think we're going to add this in a couple of these guys in there because I really think we need some red. I definitely think we do. Because we got enough yellow and enough orange, I think. We need to put some red in there and then call it a skip dank of the doom day. Okay, yeah, we need some red. Figure this guy out. Okay, you have to go that way. So, don't know if I'm gonna add any more flowers because I think we got those flowers that we put in there might have been just enough for enough flowers for what we need, but I definitely think we needed some color, and I think these red leaves are helping me do that. So yes, feel free, you guys, just play around with it. It's more like a just what looks good type of ordeal. If you know how to cut a tool, you know how to dip it in hot glue, and then stick it into a thing. And just see what looks good. I think anyone can make a wreath like this, you guys. You do not have to be a talented wreath maker or anything to do something like this. Just have fun with it. If you're making it for your house, anything you make, you should be happy and proud to show off inside your house. And yeah, so just go with the flow. If you don't know what to buy, kind of start with what's your main focal point is. What do you want in it? Maybe you want a sign. Maybe you were at the store and you found this really cool fall ribbon. Well then, what's colors in the ribbon? Maybe there's orange, maybe it's colors like mine, or maybe it's like a brown and a red. So start picking out stuff that you think is gonna match. You don't wanna come in here with some purple if your ribbon is over here with the color yellow in it. You don't wanna have purple in it. So you kind of just want to go with the flow of things, choose colors that match, and then that's all it really is. It's basically just color choice. Your color choice is key on making your wreath look good, and then just start doing it. Do you want a bow? Do you have a sign? Do you want a bow with it? If you do, what colors are in your sign that would make your ribbon look good? You don't want to have a yellow sign and come in here with some purple ribbon because that's just not going to match. So you want to make sure everything that you're using kind of color combinates, like, goes together. You guys know what I'm talking about. Sometimes in my head it sounds a little better than what I'm really saying, but I think you guys get it. Basically, just pick colors that go together. And then just start adding. Start with your greenery, and then move on from there. Then go into your, if you want to add pine cones, if you want to add, maybe you want to add like, what else, pumpkins, maybe you want to add some little pumpkins or something in here. Maybe you're going to add leaves like me. And then what, maybe you want to add some like grass or some, anything you could, you can add literally anything into your wreath. It will be fun. And before you know it, you'll be hooked on wreath making, and you'll be able to make a wreath for your front door for every season. Or maybe you don't use it on your front door, maybe use it on your wall or your above your fireplace or wherever you hang your wreaths. And then you can make it the way you want it, and you don't have to spend all the money that you do when you go and you buy a wreath from a designer. But some people decide that they don't want to go and make their own wreath. They rather just go and buy one that's already been made, and that is perfectly fine. Some people are too busy and or don't have the taste of wanting to even do it. They'd rather just get it made them by someone else. But some people can't afford a real big, expensive wreath off of Etsy or off at a craft sale or from a wreath shop or at the craft store, but they want something for their house or for their, maybe you live in a trailer home, your trailer, or maybe you want something for your bathroom or wherever you want a wreath or some decor. Make it, but you still want it, that's when you go in and you make it yourself. You DIY it. You choose your, how much you want to spend. Maybe you want to spend $30. Well, then you go out and you buy a grapevine, or you buy a, a wreath form and some deco mesh, and you make it yourself. The dollar store has some nice signs for each season. So that's what it looks like for right now. I think I'm gonna put a hanger on it, and I'm gonna go and hang it on the wall and see what it looks like from there. I moved myself around, so I'm like I was just looking there, like, where is my wire? In the basket now, Max. So, if you haven't watched any of my other videos, I make a simple wire or wreath out, or hanger out of just some wire that I get from the Walmart. Looks like this. It is 16 gauge galvanized steel wire. Get it at Walmart. I measure out about 4 inches ish. Where is my pliers? Oh, it's over here. And then I just go over here with the end. I kind of just poke this down. I use the same method when I'm using deco mesh too. So if you're making a deco mesh wreath, I use it the same way. I kind of hook the corners. I decide where, I'm gonna kind of do this off camera because I kind of decide where I want my mesh or my hanger to go. And I'm just gonna hang it right on one of these twigs. There we go. So I did it right on that twig. Looks good to me. Kind of push them together. This way they're kind of intertwined, so they shouldn't be. It's a little easier when you're working, if you're using a deco mesh and you're just using a wreath form. I just put it around one of the different wires. Here you're going through twigs and stuff, so it's going to be a little bit more difficult, but you'll get it. There we go. I just crushed the wire. So I'm going to quick go and hang it up on the wall since I don't have my wreath easel yet. I need to get one. Still looking for one. If you guys have one and you have no place to get a good, nice wreath easel that you can, like a floor one, let me know. I'm kind of just pulling out. I'm in search of one. They're kind of expensive, and I'm like, ugh. So I thought maybe me and my dad could make one. Because my dad, he's not really a carpenter, but he does construction, so. Okay, guys, you guys are going to get a little dizzy because I'm going to take you off the tripod. And we're going to head on through my messy bedroom. And we're going to go on the wall, and right there is our finished grapevine wreath. Kind of a simpler wreath. I didn't go too extravagant. That's not the word. Whatever. I didn't go too big. Sometimes I come down a lot more and let things hang. But since I'm just using my scraps from home, whatever I had left in my stash, this is what I'm using. So I'm just using what I had for today. This is more of a simpler one. I might go through and just add some more greenery tomorrow or whenever I get my shipment. I might do a haul, you guys. I might do an unboxing of my wreath box. But yes, this is a grapevine wreath with the bow with the florals or and leaves and pine cones and that kind of stuff. So yeah, hope you got some inspiration or got some ideas on what to do for your wreath if you're making a fall wreath. Probably not. I don't know if you're a designer maybe right now, but if you're just someone looking to make a wreath for your house, more than likely you're not thinking about fall right now. You're more into summer or 4th of July still. So yes, guys, this is my video for today. Hope you like it. Make sure to like, comment down below what's your favorite season to make wreaths with. And if you know anywhere to get a wreath easel for the floor, let me know that too. Otherwise, subscribe if you like my videos and turn on your post notifications so you get notified every time I upload a video. It's been a long day, you guys. Until then, you guys, goodbye.